Good morning, guys, and welcome back to my channel. Or if you are new here, welcome. Today we are coming to you straight from Thailand. I'm on a health retreat in Koh Samui at the moment right now with my mum. So I thought today what I would do is show you what I'm eating in my health retreat, and then also afterwards I will take you through some questions that you guys asked me over on my Instagram. So it is an absolutely beautiful morning today. I'm running late for a yoga class. I just had to do some work emails and stuff like that, but I got a bit burnt yesterday. It's kind of gone down now. But yeah, if you are interested in seeing what I eat during the day while I'm at this yoga retreat, not yoga retreat, sorry, while I'm at this health and fitness retreat, I'll also be definitely implementing this when I get home into my diet as well. But you just need to have a look at this view. Hold on. Like, that's straight outside of our little villa. So yeah, I'm off to yoga now, but I will check in with you guys when I have my first meal. I've already had a juice this morning, which I totally forgot to film. But when I go over to the breakfast bar, I will show you what juice I had. And yeah. Okay, so mum and I are at breakfast and we just finished yoga. So what we have here is the menu. So I'll run you through not all, but the juices that we've been pretty much having every single day. So right now mum and I are both on a raw vegan diet. So a lot of you asked what's the difference between being just normal vegan and raw vegan. So at the end of the video, I'll do a sit down question and answer from the questions you guys asked me on my Instagram. So this morning I had the cool and hydrating juice. So mum and I have been trying to go on fasted cardio every morning. We've only done it once while we've been here. We've been here for 4 days?
Three days.
So I had, as I said, cool and hydrating. So it's best for both detoxing and hydration. It has parsley and coriander to help clean out heavy metals from the body. So in that, it has cucumber, parsley, coriander, green lettuce, guava, and pineapple. And then mum had the pineapple love. I usually have this at lunchtime. It's really good for digestion. So it has pineapple, cucumber, ginger, celery, and mint. So for breakfast this morning, we are also having a big bowl of fruit that has mango, papaya, dragon fruit, and pineapple. And then we sprinkle on top bee pollen and is it hemp. And I'm going to have also guacamole and some toast. And then I will show you when we get all of our food. But so it is lunchtime now. It's 2:04, so we're eating lunch a little bit late. I just had PT session with Alex and we did upper body, which was awful, not gonna lie. But we usually try and eat lunch around this time, if not a little bit earlier. I haven't had anything since breakfast, so.
Mummy, what did you get?
I got fresh spring rolls and guacamole.
No, they're nori.
That's fine, it's pretty right, because I haven't had one.
Okay, mum's allergic to fish. Well, anything seafood really. So I'm gonna go and have a look at the menu and see what I fancy. Probably should only eat raw, but I really wanna try that Asian bowl that has tofu in it. I can't have tofu, so I'm not meant to have soy foods at all. So obviously soy is in tofu, but let's go have a look at the menu. Hello. Also, I'm sorry if I keep looking there. It's just the viewfinder's right there and I'm like used to, I don't know, looking there. But first up, we have the raw cacao smoothie. So, thanks, Mum. In here, there's frozen banana, raw cacao, young coconut, date, cinnamon, and vanilla. Honestly, so yummy. And it's good for... So it's got high levels of folic acid, vitamin B, and antioxidants. What's folic acid?
Well, it's a thing good for reproductive system.
Now you know. And then I also got a mango salsa dip, and it's like a mango chutney, I guess. And it's served with veggies and lettuce, but I got toast to add with that as well. And I also got a raw tabbouleh, salad. So this is finely chopped cauliflower, coriander, tomato, celery, red onion, herbs, lemon juice, olive oil, seasons with white and black pepper, sea salt, crushed garlic. And yeah, I've had that pretty much every day since we've been here and it's so yummy. And okay, so this is the mango chutney thing. Got some veggie sticks. I've asked for another piece of toast. You left your phone here.
Yeah, I wonder where it was.
Yeah. And then also this is the tabbouleh salad. So as I said, it's got cauliflower and other stuff in it. But yeah, I'm gonna chow down on that. Right, well this is this is interesting. I've got Mum holding the light, my phone light. Anyway, we're just off to dinner. It's, what's the time?
About 6:30.
It's about 6:30. Yeah, I'll show you what we're having. We usually have a salad, standard, and then some fruit. So let's head on over. So tonight on the menu, we have black rice. This is the first cooked thing I've had in days. No, not days, that's dramatic, like 4 days. So we have a coconut curry or coconut cream curry. So it's got heaps of vegetables. It's got potatoes, green beans, carrots, capsicum, and then other herbs and spices. And we have black rice. So I'm super excited to eat this. And I also have a tea. And Mum got some guac and a juice. So yeah. So next up on the menu is a big bowl of papaya with that stuff there.
Can you see it?
Is bee pollen. Very unsure what it does for you, but it tastes really nice. It's kind of like crunchy honey. But yeah, we're just gonna have this.
That was such bad lighting. Wow, that's shocking. I'm gonna have this and then probably have a tea. And then we'll go to bed. Yeah.
So, in this part of the video, I'm going to be explaining about my retreat and answering the questions that you guys asked me on my Instagram story the other day. So, let me start off. First question is, what is the name of the retreat you are on and what is the cost involved? So I'm on Orion Retreat and it's in Koh Samui, Thailand. So my mum and I are doing the 7-day fitness one, but there are lots of different options that you can choose from. There's longer ones or shorter ones as well. So basically for 7 days, you get accommodation. So the accommodation is relatively really nice. It's really comfortable. It's rated 3-star, which is totally fine. I mean, the most important thing, it's got a comfortable bed, electricity, water, air conditioning, and the staff are absolutely amazing. So the total cost, so as I said, the accommodation, so Mum and I have a 2-bedroom villa. All foods are included as well. All of your personal training sessions are included. So Mum and I get one a day. Yoga classes daily for 1.5 hours. And massages are included, a Reiki session, which I might do a separate video on that, because that was probably like one of the most amazing experiences I've had so far on this retreat. I'm only in day 4, so Mum and I have 3 more days to go. Oh, and free unlimited water, which is vital. Because obviously you can't brush your teeth and stuff with the water. And it was roughly, this is without flights, I think about nearly $3,000 each. So that's actually like, I mean, that's a lot of money, but what you get out of it, for health reasons, it's so beneficial. But yeah, so that's the first question. I'm not going to answer all of them. I'm pretty much just going to answer the most common ones. So the next question is, what is the difference between being normal vegan and raw vegan? So I'm only just learning about this now. So essentially being, I guess, your standard vegan is that you eat cooked foods, so cooked vegetables, grains, like carbs, like all of that stuff. But being raw vegan is that you don't eat anything cooked, so you pretty much eat anything raw. It's as simple as it sounds, really. My diet on this retreat, as you would have seen, is all raw foods, or technically like 90% raw foods. And then I will slowly start implementing cooked foods as my gut heals. Oh, this is a good one. Are you worried about losing weight or gaining weight when you are on this health retreat? So, as some of you may have known if you're following me on Instagram, I lost about 10 to 12 kilos at the start of the year due to me being really unwell, not only physically but mentally. I was in a very dark place. So I lost, as I said, heaps of weight. And it's been really hard for me to gain it back on slowly and healthily. So I'm trying to gain the weight back on really steadily, listening to my body and understanding what it needs to function well. I am eating bigger quantities of food. So my mom isn't eating as much as me, even though she is eating the same foods. I'm just eating more quantity of that food, if that makes sense. About gaining weight, that's my goal, is to gain weight. So I'm not particularly worried about the gaining weight aspect. And this retreat is really good because what you do when you first get here, you have a consultation with a health and wellness manager, and they pretty much will talk to you and they will want to know your end goals, if you have any issues. For me personally, my issue was my digestion. All of my lesions from endometriosis was pretty much through my bowels and intestines. So like TMI, but through that, when I've had operations, it's just really, I guess, ruined the lining of my intestines and also my bowel as well, which is not ideal. So by doing this, I guess, cleanse detox, it's really helped to repair my gut. And if you guys want, I can do a whole video on that, but it might be like, am I in focus? This is my first time using this camera, guys, so I'm really sorry that it's probably not going to be the best, but I'm trying. Anyway, so yeah, my mum is really good at researching and finding the best deals. So as I said, on Google reviews, TripAdvisor, whatever other site you review places on, this had really good reviews, amazing reviews, and I can see why. I know I don't need to say this, but I'm not being sponsored to say this. They didn't fly us over here at all. Mum and I both paid for this trip, so it wasn't, I'm not being paid to say this at all, guys. This is my honest review. These are my honest thoughts about this place. It is absolutely beautiful. They really open up your eyes to a lot of different things and what you learn about. And they open up your eyes to a lot of different things. But keep in mind what one person is taught and what another person is taught might not be right for you. So what I'm saying and what I'm doing right now might not be right for you. Everybody's bodies are different. They function differently. You know what's best for you. You know what's best for your health. And if you're ever thinking about trying what I'm doing at the moment, always go and speak to your doctor first, just to make sure that you are able to do this and you won't have any like issues. Why is that there? I feel like that should be there. Anyway, yeah, so you like won't have any issues or, yeah. Next question. Okay, this one's a good one. Do you feel that yoga slash meditation has had a major impact on your mindset? Honestly, I have only, so I used to do yoga a lot when I was a dancer, when I was younger. And I guess when you're younger, you don't really think of the mindfulness aspect of yoga. Like, at least that was with me. I didn't really think about that aspect a lot, but this trip has been honestly really, like, I don't know how to word it. It's been really good, not only for my physical health, but my mental health. Learning to, I guess, like, how do I say this without sounding like really lame? I don't know, it's been really good to learn a lot more about myself and learn that it's okay to, I mean, I always preach this, like, it's okay not to be okay, but I'm the type of person where I suppress everything and anything. Like, I just feel really uncomfortable talking about certain things to certain people. I honestly, and this might be for you as well, I honestly prefer talking to a stranger about my problems. I just feel it comes a lot easier to me because I don't feel as judged compared to if I speak to someone that may know me personally. I don't know if that's just me or if that's other people, but when I had my Reiki session, I posted on my private Instagram that it was just so overwhelming how suppressed I have become over the years with my emotions. I've been in years and years in therapy, and I've never felt a connection to my psychologist or psychiatrist like I felt towards the man that did the Reiki. I don't know, it was like an out-of-body experience. Personally, like, I did not believe in anything like this at all. I thought it was just all like whack, and I think I had a really closed mind to it, and I came in this with a really open mind because I wanted to try like anything and everything, not only to help me, but to help my mum as well. As you guys know, my mum's been unfortunately really unwell for the past few months. So I really wanted to take this opportunity to try and, I guess, have an open mind for both of us and to try new things. Mum's never done, oh no, she has done yoga, but she's done it years ago. And it was really good to see mum try like everything. And like, wow, I go on tangents. Going back to your question, I feel, I guess, more like zen, I don't know, but I feel a lot more like at peace with myself. And I was talking to Matt as well, and we have something really exciting coming up next year, hopefully in January or February, so stay tuned, about everything. And I think that he was really impressed that I was able to come out of my shell, because it's just not like me at all. Yeah, I don't know. Anyway, back to the questions. Fair. How have you found not being able to take supplements if you are still allowed to take your supplements? So I've chosen not to take any of my supplements. Obviously I'm still taking my daily medication, like my vitamins and stuff like that. But I'm not taking any OxyShred, my protein powder. I started taking at the start of the retreat, and then I was speaking to Anna, who is the wellness, I think she's like the wellness manager. She's absolutely beautiful, she's amazing. And she said that to help heal my gut, I need to actually consume less protein. So I've cut out my protein powder. I miss it so much, but I can slowly start implementing that as the days go on. I can slowly start implementing more protein. But I feel like that was kind of all of the general questions. I mean, the main question was, what do you eat while you're there? And like, I'm filming that right now, so you guys would have already seen it. But if you have any other questions, honestly, just drop me a message. I try to reply to everyone as fast as possible. I'm really slack on my phone at the moment, so I'm just trying to like enjoy my time. Sorry if the camera's moved at all. I just got up. Oh my God, the sun is so beautiful. This place is like honestly amazing. Like it's, I don't know, it's great. I feel like that's everything. I know I would have forgotten something, so I might have to include more stuff in like another video, or if I get asked any more questions, then I'll have to, obviously, people keep walking past, it's really awkward. I'll have to obviously just like answer them. No. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope that also the video quality is okay. As I said, I'm still getting used to this camera. I feel like I'm, like when I'm sitting down now, I'm more focusing on like the actual lens than here. So I hope that wasn't too annoying at the start. But if you would, I hate doing this part, it's so awkward. Like thumbs up this video, like, but I mean like, please thumbs up this video because apparently you get more like views or something, I don't know. But if you haven't already, subscribe down below. Wowie, subscribe. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. I'll get better at this, I promise. But make sure you make sure you subscribe and switch the bell icon on so you get notified every time I post a video. Sorry, I don't know why I find myself funny. I literally think I'm fucking hilarious, but I'm not. Oh, another thing I need to show you. Okay, hold please. So, what I was trying to show you before is that I put on my fruit salad in the morning. It's hemp and bee pollen. So I don't know what this does, but we just got given it. And then in the morning we get maca and wheatgrass. This tastes awful. This, not so much. It tastes kind of nice, kind of crunchy. But yeah, if I forget anything else, I'll just like film some more, but I think that's it.